got reset. Oh, it's even brought the map up. Ah, here we go. Right, drive the RE5315 from Hossack to Sankt Gorgon. You'll drive across the Reichenbach viaduct at Hornburg and drive through 37 tunnels. The train will climb from 241 metres altitude in Hossack up to the European Continental Divide, Rhine-Danube, at 834 metres altitude at Sommerau. Expect route clearance at 10:17. Departure is 10:18 in Hossack. There's no PZB on this loco, or this route even, I don't think. Hang on a minute, what's going on with track IR? It's gone a bit bonkers. It's better. Right. Epic Droid Gaming, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. As you had the info, we would remember it. No, not at all. I forgot the top bit. Yes, I did forget the top bit. Kausbeck, thank you for the host. This is Hornburg. Apparently I'm supposed to pick up passengers over there. What? How's that work then? I'm on track two. It says pick up passengers from track one. What am I missing here, folks? Hornburg track one, yeah, but that I'm in track two. Help me. Are we in the wrong track? Or is this the wrong instruction? Track bus train sim player, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. None of these are set to cross over. There's no instruction telling me to restart. Well, this is brilliant, isn't it? What a great... K-Dog, thank you for the host. Sparrow, thank you for the host. Thank you, everybody, for the host. Okay, so that's not a fabulous start. I don't quite know whether I've done something wrong here, or whether... I think, given that... I think we're possibly... Hang on, we're facing the wrong direction. Are we supposed to be going the other way? There's no cab car on the back. Oh, seriously. What's the rogue piece of track? It's probably a... Let's have a look, shall we? Oh, it's this. It's the river. So, what it looks like is the loco is in the wrong direction and it's on the wrong track. Or rather, the instructions in the wrong track. Because I suspect that's the right track. We're just facing the wrong direction, the instructions wrong. Let's check the next instruction. We will just fix this scenario in just a minute. No, apparently we're going to go down that way. No, that is the right track, isn't it? Because we drive on the right. And then we're going into track two. Yep, okay, I could believe track two. So we're in the wrong place, is the problem here. No fancy loop that I would expect to do. That's Hossack. Oh, this is us here. Ah. Then looking up. Completely the wrong train. So Hornburg track one. So the scenario is absolutely fine and I'm just completely looking at the wrong thing. There you go. Business as usual. Have we got our light yet? We've got our light. Let's go ahead, shall we? Oh. I blame not playing the game for ages. I've completely forgotten how to play it. Been screaming at me about that, have you? Oh well. Nothing new there. Hey, Dan. And away we go. I don't know what everyone's complaining about this. This looks really quite good, actually. Hundred limit. I've put track IR smoothing on as well to see if that eliminates some of the. It looked like there was some stutter coming from track IR. What are you driving? We are driving a BR143. I've also FPS limited it, so it's frame locked at 60 FPS. Which I'm hoping will keep it balanced. What is TS Pro? TS Pro is a new range, or it's a reclassification of some existing locos. If you are a new user and you come into Train Simulator, I missed a donation. Oh man, I need to get better practice at this. Let me just check. Yeah, so if you've got the TS Pro, Gouger donated £5. Thank you very much, Gouger. No message. Yeah, so if you were new and you came to Train Simulator, you could pick up the FEF just thinking, hey, it's a train, and be completely confused and have no idea why you can't drive it. And we don't tell you that it's a hard loco to drive. So the Pro range is there to clearly mark out locos which are going to require extra effort and complicated, more real, shall we say, and will require you to just get on with it. Siemens, this is a really old BR143. This BR143 dates right back to the original game that was launched in 2009. Seven X Ninja, thank you for the host. If I've missed any hosts, I do apologise, folks. It's much appreciated. So this map is the Black Forest route is really quite large, but not all of it has got scenery. So the Schwarzwald Barn, Black Forest, is here, and it's with this bit here, particularly. This is the really well known bit. Train. And then I think the other scenery part is from here all the way along to here. And then I think this branch down here has got scenery as well. But this line up here does not. It's tracked and signaled, I think, but you just can't. It's got no scenery on it. So we're on our way up. Frame rate's holding steady at 60, which is good. Great Western Geek, should you buy this route? I mean, one of the reasons I run it is so that you can make up your own mind, and because I want to see it. I love the detail on the trees over there, that looks quite nice. I don't want to recommend whether you run it or not. What I would say is that it's not through, it isn't up to the fidelity of a modern, a current route. I don't think it costs the same either, I think it's quite cheap. and it doesn't come with any new stock. It uses old rail simulator stock, so it's you need to work out, I guess, if that's what's important to you and if that matters. I believe I've seen someone, like Rubco, I think, was talking about retracking the route with one of the more modern track models, which would be quite nice. And then there's no reason why someone can't change all the signals with PZB ones from, say, the Hamburg-Lübeck route or something. So it may well be that across workshop, people can actually modernise the technology on this route. There's no working PZB, that's a shame. But such a pretty part of the world. Have I driven the Class 90? I've pretty much driven everything in the game one way or another. In fact, I brought the Class 90 onto Steam, talking to working with Armstrong Powerhouse when I was head of third party. Similar to what Zawel did with the Seaburg one. Absolutely, Francois. In fact, that's a really good example. This route's got German signalling, Dr. Anthony, but it does not have PZB90, which is the cab signalling. So PZB90. Sorry, apparently I can't look down because my track IR needs adjusting. Let's open the doors, lock the track IR. Let me just check this. So this is the PZB cab signalling indicators, which don't work on this model of the BR143. There is another BR143 by Virtual Railroads, which is on Steam, and that is excellent. If I had more time, then I would be updating all the scenarios to use that version of the 143, because that's a beautiful model. It's another quite old one, but it's had Virtual Railroads' attention. There's your horn, Sanu. Heading for Triberg now. I don't really have pet peeves about watching other people. I'm interested to see what people are doing. If they're not doing it right, then it presumably means that they're not being told to do it, or they don't know to do it right. And I don't do it right half the time, because I just make a decision that, you know what, I'm going to have fun and not follow the rules, because this is a game. I forgot the top bit. Yeah, I know, Danish bacon lover. It'll have to wait. I'll get there. I'll get everything updated at some point. Has everyone noticed, by the way, that my background is a BR143, and I haven't had done a thing. It did it all automatically. Anyone who was watching the coding stream saw me. I wrote a plugin live on the stream where the background image here is actually connected to the game and is watching what the game is doing. And when I change the loco, it automatically switches the background image inside OBS, which is pretty cool. It seems to work all right. My favourite ICE? I don't know, actually. Probably the 3M, just because it's raw speed. Next would be the TD, I think. Yeah, this cab will have an uninvited guest because it was taken with... it was taken with the driver model still in there. Hey there, butter mister. Still hitting 60 FPS. That's one good thing. One of the really positive bits about the way this route has been built is that it will run on anyone's system really well. Your YouTube channel has been doing TS 2016 Let's Plays. Nice, Dr. Anthony. Nice. I don't know what I'm going to do on Wednesday. I'm probably not going to do Train Sim. I might do either a different game or a coding stream, depending on how I feel and how late the Minecraft stream ends. Sometimes the Minecraft streams go on for 3 and a bit hours, which is the time they're done. I'm sort of not interested in doing anything else. The Minecraft stream is intended to be 2 hours. So if that happens, then I might do something, because I want to do a bit more work on TS Connect. If I can do a bit more work on TS Connect, that might be a thing to do. Right, so we've got the first of the tunnel. So this part of the route, if we just have a quick look, you can see where we are. It's all tunnels and all sorts of things going on here. So this is where it gets really quite interesting. It's tunnel, tunnel, tunnel. Well, Subnautica was one of the options I was thinking about flying Scotsman. This part of the route is really pretty. I appreciate some of the people are complaining some of the assets that they used are quite old, but I just... really like the detail in this part of the route. It's really nicely done. Danish Bacon Lover, my plan is, this is an experiment, this week is an experiment to see if I can start the stream earlier. I mean, we almost got there today, so we'll see whether we generally do get working or whether we're always, if I always end up about 8:30, then I'll set my early time at 8:30. My goal is to get to 8 o'clock. But we'll see how we get on. Oh, has anyone seen the new Evening Star Class 66 in BR lined green? I think it looks quite fetching, actually, although I can see why some people might have objection. Shore Trains, I can't remember what the name of the start and end points are. We're riding along the Black Forest part of the route. You Google Class 66 Evening Star, you should be able to get some pictures. Basically, it's a Class 66 that GBRF have repainted into British Rail green, lined, as if it was a steam engine almost. They've got the BR Green logo that you see on a tender, and just above where it says the Class 66 number, it says 9F. And then it's actually got a big plaque on the side that says not Evening Star on it. And of course, the 66 Evening Star is at the NRM, where the steam engine Evening Star is. So I do hope that the NRM are taking the opportunity to get the Evening Star out of storage, where it was when I was there, and stick it next to the Class 66. Yes, it is the last class 66 Adama. That's why it's been given the name Evening Star, because the Evening Star steam engine was the last steam engine built at Swindon. It was outside when 66 arrived. Oh, in that case, it probably will be pushed in alongside then. I kind of have a hankering to go up to York. My favourite steam engine. I'm quite enjoying this as a ride. I can imagine it'd be a lot more difficult going down it though, because of the grade changes. Lots and lots of tunnels. Short trains, did I enjoy the NRM? Absolutely. The NRM was great. No, this is a nice looking route actually. I'm really enjoying this. Oh dear. We've hit 60 FPS the entire way along, which is quite satisfying, actually. Tunnel, 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 tunnel. 37 of them in total. This one appears to be filled in. So this, whenever you see this is actually a bug in the game, not the route. Occasionally the decals, which are used to get rid of the landscape, just don't render for some reason. It's one of those really randomly sporadic bugs that's really hard to track down. Morning to the horse, thank you for the host, much appreciated. It's Francois, 60 FPS at 720p, absolutely. Have I been keeping track of what tunnel number I'm on? Not in the slightest. Oh, coming up on Triberg, I do want to get a... Yeah, I know what you mean, Katie. Once the decal's down, it's hard to move it again, isn't it? I end up placing it somewhere completely different. Do I have a Twitch partnership? No, I don't have a Twitch partnership, Curb Noob. I applied and they said no. So, I'll try again another time. crossing over here. Curb noob, that's the first I've heard about that. Coming into track three. Well, I'm broadcasting at 60 FPS now, Curb Noob. They don't really have any limits for non-partners now. Julian, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Arnold, I think there's a lot of different people with different ideas of what the requirements are. I mean, I think actually it's different. They look at a lot of different things because I know people that only get 100 plus that get that have been given partnerships. So to be honest, it doesn't really matter. If we get partnership, we get partnership. If we don't, we'll just play trains until we get partnership. Then we'll play more trains. Yeah, Francois, even if your bitrate goes too high, they can block it. But I think that even applies to the partners. I think they have a limit of 3,500, and if you go above 3,500, then they start getting grumpy. And to be perfectly honest, if you go above 3,500, the number of people who can actually watch your stream without buffering goes down very rapidly. So, I mean, that limit is there not just for technical reasons, but more actually for being sensible. Just tell them how sad you'll be if you don't get partnership. I shall put that in there as well. In fact, I will say both Fringe and I may not smile for a day or so if we don't get partnership. If you are prepared to live with that, then fair enough. Of course, the thing is, if you with the limit of 3,500, you're actually in a slightly... It means that you should never do 1080p 60 FPS because you cannot do the amount of bits per pixel goes down so far. The quality of the stream is so far is so low that you actually lose all the benefit of doing that. So you either want to do 1080p 30 FPS or 720p 60 FPS. Right, runaway for Sankt Gorgon. Did anyone see Modern Railways in the April issue? There's a Crossrail pullout in there. Did anyone see that? Good night, Butter Mister. Wow, we very briefly had a decent speed limit there, and then it all of a sudden it vanished. Oh yeah, I'm not going to get a glod on this scenario. Oh, we've got another tunnel mouth that's filled in. If we get 334 at the next one, we're due to about 840, which isn't too shabby. Good night, French Stalin. God, we haven't even got to where we normally start, and I'm saying good night to everybody. Oh, Danish bacon lover. Good night. V200. Dr. Anthony, what's CIFA? It's a driver vigilance system. Basically, it will come up every 60 seconds or so and say, hey, no problem at all, French. You go, mate. You go, mate. Do what you've got to do. So yeah, CIFA's a vigilance system, sets an alarm off every 30 to 60 seconds. Yeah, the V200 is the loco that the warship was based on. That's a lot of trees. So one of the things I'm going to do after we've done, we're going to do this German route, but then we've got two British scenarios. For the last one, I noticed that the author of Majestic Falls has done a new route, I thought I would start by looking at that one. So that one for America. So that's the Blackwood Creek, I think it is, which looks really good. Joshua, this does not have this is the old BR143, so it doesn't have all of the it doesn't have PWLC4 or anything like that. Sadly. Train Point, thank you for the host, much appreciated. Schreckmeister, I don't know about the S160 release date, I'm afraid. 8 kilometers to go. A diesel hydraulic. So a diesel hydraulic is where it talks about where the transmission between the engine and the gearing and the wheels. You have this thing called a hydraulic fluid coupling, and sometimes you have multiple fluid couplings. And it basically just, you have a propeller which then spins fluid and oil which then spins, and then the oil then causes an impeller to spin round, and then that's where how the energy gets transferred across. That's fundamentally what a diesel hydraulic is. That's why you'll hear them spin up, and then as they speed up, they stay at the same RPM sound, and then at some point they actually slow right down again, and that's when it drops them out of one fluid coupling and puts it in the other fluid coupling or torque converter. They're subtly different. This is similar. Curb Noob, thank you for the host. Hey Ron Wirral, welcome. Shrekmeister, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Cafe, yes, so when I was looking up recently, I did happen to see the pictures of the warship painted up as a V-200. I thought it looked rather fetching, actually. Chris Child, thank you for the host. Going to be gone. You can't hear audio. I would give you some advice, but you won't be able to hear me. Maybe someone can advise that he checks his the setting down the bottom on Twitch. Logan 19077, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Oh, we're all the way down here now, so we've gone round the tunnels and spirally stuff. Tunnel. We're nearly there. 4 kilometres is not too much further. Kazbek, not too much longer now. Seld UK, yeah, that power car they've repainted in BR Blue Grey is gorgeous. Looks very, very nice. Shame they haven't done a whole set, because that would look amazing. Really got to watch your speed on this route like a hawk. Me looking over at the chat all the time really isn't helping. So speed up. Route is nice in the snow, is it, Rob? I haven't looked. We'll have to do another scenario at some point in the snow. I want to try and look over the course of the next couple of weeks at all the different bits that are included in this route. Good night, Adama. pulling into Sankt Georgen or Gorgon, Gorgon, Jorgen? I don't know. Just making it up at this point. Got another 5 minutes before we're due in. Timings on this scenario are quite loose. So while we stop, just take another quick look at the map. So we just drove from Halsach, I think it is, down the Schwarzwaldbahn to Sankt Georgen. So that's that bit. The route carries on with full scenery down to here. I believe it also has scenery across the bottom here. And then there's also this branch line down here. So I don't think there's many scenery here. And I don't know if there's scenery up here. There is a small tramway line here. I believe. Open the door, shall we? H21. Well, given all the overspeeding, that wasn't too bad a run, actually. Got a silver. Right, Riviera Ramble Part 2. So before I went offline, I did Riviera Ramble Part 1. So let's changing route.